Greetings, everyone. My name is Etterville, and welcome to my let's try of the second demo of Turbo Leaper, a 2D action platformer in development by Regalsoft. World 1, the adventure begins. You zip around pretty quickly. What was that? Interdimensional tunnel. Ouch. My toe touched the red beam of that. No? What happened there? Am I not allowed to collect the card? Guess not. Corrupted Binori. Danger blocks intrusion. So these are instant death. What's up with those cards? Spring cliffs. Got glued to the wall. So for this adventure, we're traveling between dimensions. Something happened to our peaceful platformer world, and now it's up to us to fix the problem. I jumped right. Go away, Binori. Not only are the portals opening up everywhere, but some enemies are being corrupted as well. I like how fast you move and respawn. Cranian? What are you doing here? We got the boost command. I like how fast you move and respawn. Ouch. And I reset back here because I missed the checkpoint. However, I still have my dash ability. That didn't get reset. Well, I found the first bug here. I can't re-enter the boss room. I was supposed to hit the checkpoint, but I accidentally skipped it. Oops. I guess we have to restart the adventure. I'm assuming what was supposed to happen is I was gonna fight the boss there. It placed the blocks behind me to prevent me from backtracking, but because my last checkpoint was before that point, it ended up softlocking me. You may want to place a checkpoint at the start of every level, or make the checkpoint flags bigger. Calogonisk Wing. It's absorbed some of the freak energy. See, that wasn't that bad. We rescued Cranian from Super Freaks. Now it's time for the Winter Challenge. Select from a choice of four characters. Merry Christmas, Scruffy. Enjoyed his cool hat and Snow Go Yo-Yo. Rocking the classic designs for the Super Freaks. Meanwhile, in the Budverse... Oh no. The Red Wizards acquiring their power. I'm feeling cold. My heater broke down. I need a new heating unit. The Corrupted Wizard kidnaps a young man and makes his way through many portals, catching the eye of Ellie Tacticat. If you don't recognize most of these characters, don't worry. They are from various other games featured during this age. So I'm playing as Eris from Bud. She has a Snow Bud, which fires snowballs. What's up with this card anyways? Whoa. I don't trust you, Ice Cube. Do different characters have different levels? Whoa! That was a super boost pad if I've seen one. We made it to Mizzouli. It's been frozen solid. Mizzouli originates from Bud, which is Eris's universe. These are the bouncy goo blocks. There we go. Okay, let's see that again. This is the way you're supposed to do it. Well, time to bring out the ice skates then. They just stood there, menacingly. Cool and chill, breaking out. Oh no, it's evil Mr. Shoot'em. Bounce up, please. Let's retry this. I can't run into him. Ice physics, whoa. You accelerate really fast in the ice. I never actually played Mr. Shoot'em during Sage. It's basically a cross between Breakout and a shooter. Oh my goodness, get me out, get me out. You'll clone this guy 40 times? And that's no good. In that machine, localized to this single phenomenon? Versus Corrupted Winter Wizard. Santa? With Eris, this is very easy. We saved Christmas, folks. Oh, I'm certain that if I play as a different character, the boss becomes less of a joke. Thanks for playing. We've unlocked a bunch of other characters. Winter Classic Scruffy, Eris and Snowbud, Ellie the Tacticat, Fred, Battlesuit Scruffy, Gamby, King Quincy, Tiki Man, The Player, Alchemist, Brick, Mr. Shoot'em, and Nadine. I want to see Fred. Oh yeah. Fred is basically hard mode, as he can only hop and bop. Which means that if I were to face off against Evil Santa again, it'd be a lot harder. I don't trust you. Meanwhile, Scruffy, he has this yo-yo, which can be used to damage enemies. It's more tricky to use than the guns, however. Like Fred, he can also hop and bop. So in effect, he's a straight upgrade compared to Fred. Let's try out Ellie. She's basically like Mega Man Classic. Can fire as fast as you can button mash, but only if she has less than 3 projectiles on screen. Battlesuit Scruffy. And I can arc my shots too. Gamby. Whoa, what did that do? He creates a temporary bubble he can swim in. So, water physics on demand, folks. King Quincy. Only one shot at a time, but I guess it deals more damage. Tiki Man. I don't really see any difference here. He doesn't have a projectile attack attached to him. The Player. Smiley Face. Basically a palette swap of Fred. Alchemist. Palette swap of Ellie. Yes, with the shooter characters, you can also hop and bop. Brick joke, anyone? Mr. Shoot'em. Oh my goodness, they're the best shooter character here. They fire as fast as you can button mash, but they don't have a 3-shot limit. And just like all the other characters, they can hop and bop. Nadine doesn't have a 3-shot limit either, but her fire rate is fixed. You can't button mash to fire faster with her. In this title, any character who can shoot is a straight upgrade from the purely hop and bop ones. As such, this places Mr. Shoot'em on top tier. But to be fair, this is an optional challenge mode with a bunch of guest star characters from various other series. so I'm okay with the power imbalance. Sometimes, it's fun to tear through games. I actually missed an entire episode of the campaign because I didn't press right on the episode select screen. Surfing USC. This is a Super Freaks themed one, starring John Super Freaks Scruffy. Mid-boss, Rotten Bony. Hop and Bop till its destruction. Cardboard Cove. Nearly get crushed by the platforms. One of Sticky's old tanks. And it's been corrupted. Watch out for the cannon counter attack. I found the easy button. Whoa. Interesting. Darn, they're spiky in the top. Extra Dimensional Juice Factory. Insert funny team song here. Whoa. Boss time, Pseudo Scruffy the Second. Keep bouncing on the weak point. Now Singe. Ow. Not as weak as he is in Super Freaks. What? Score Singe. Ah. Now we can shoot. Ah, so they gave us the battle suit. How nice of him. Victory! And thank you for the short mini campaign. As such, this truly concludes my showcase of the second demo of Turbo Leaper. As unpolished as this demo kind of is, it does have some cool ideas on display. Take for instance the battle against evil Mr. Shoot'em. I want to see a harder mode version of that. Then again, if you play as anyone who can't shoot, that fight is suitably challenging. Lastly, I do appreciate how quickly you move and how quickly you respawn. It lets you get back into the action ASAP. That being said, you should fix that soft locking issue during the first boss fight. Make it so it's harder to accidentally avoid hitting checkpoints. It's a decent little fast-paced platformer, and it has a lot of potential. In any case, decent work, Rigelsoft. I wish the best of luck to you. Well then, thanks for watching, and have a nice day.